Welcome back, everyone. Today, we will discuss the second activity in the test process, test monitoring and control. Let's start with discussing the objective of test monitoring and control. Why do we need this activity? First, we compare the actual test progress against the test plan. Are we following the plan? Are we on schedule? We can see this in the form of a graph. Here are the tests we had planned, and here are the ones we completed. In this case, we have completed more than we had planned. But if we are underperforming, then we need to take actions to meet the objectives of the test plan. What actions can we take? Do we need to change the timetable or do we need to allocate more resources? These are the decisions we have to take by going back to the planning stage. The final objective is to evaluate the exit criteria. Each stage has its own exit criteria. And this is something we keep an eye on under test monitoring and control. Until the criteria are met, that particular step will not end. Next, we look at activities. The first one is to check test results and logs. If we have failed more tests than we have passed, then we are not meeting the exit criteria. The next one is assessing the level of component or system quality. We have to check whether the quality of the system is being maintained. If we find that the quality is lacking, then we go to the planning stage and create a new plan again. The third one is determining if more test cases are needed. If the quality standards have not been maintained, then we have to find out why. Do we need more number of test cases? So these are the activities under test monitoring and control. The final segment is, why is this stage important? It's because we have to communicate with the stakeholders. Once the testing starts, the stakeholder waits for the results. We should not just hand them the final results. It should be a continuous process. We should update them regularly by letting them know when we have started the test cases and how many we have completed. Whenever they ask for information, we should always be in a position to give them answers. This is why test monitoring activity is done throughout the test process. The next point is that if there is any deviation from the plan, then we will come to know of it immediately. Instead of finding out at the end and realizing we can't meet the deadline, we will know as soon as a change happens, and we can take actions to minimize the risks. The final point is decision to stop testing. Once we meet our exit criteria, we can decide to stop the tests. So these are the elements you need to understand about test monitoring and control. What are the objectives, activities, and why these are important? That's all from this video. Until next time, happy testing.